During the latest Senate voting session, Senators Ron Rice and Dawn Adiego led an effort to condemn the President of the United States after last week's Capitol riot with a resolution calling for his removal from office, and were joined by the entire Democratic caucus in support.
This is not about whether or not you are a Trump supporter or not. It's about the freedom and democracy of this country. And for this country not to take an action, the Congress and U.S. Senate, both houses, is wrong.
But what we should not disagree upon in this House or any House is that all of us were attacked. And I'm going to tell you, the mob did not attack the Democratic people in their Capitol. They didn't attack the Democratic police officers in the Capitol. When you don't control the fervor and anger of a mob, it goes unchecked and unvarnished and moves like a flame through a wooden house.
The president commanded this group and said, let's not forget, march down. After this group was whipped into a fever, after Rudy Giuliani said, combat by tribe. They're not accidental words. No one's getting away with other wording, and this is wrong. The blame is where it belongs. When the president of the United States that did exactly what he wanted to do. It was Donald Trump, not anyone else.
Acting to help restaurants suffering from the financial impact of the COVID-19 pandemic, the Senate approved a bill sponsored by Senator Paul Sarlo, Senator Nellie Poe, and Senator Vingopal to expand opportunities for restaurants, bars, distilleries, and breweries to operate outdoors until at least November 30th, 2022, regardless of when full-capacity indoor dining is permitted to resume.
This is important and it is timely. Restaurants, bars, distilleries, and breweries have experienced significant business losses because of the coronavirus crisis, the resulting shutdowns, and reduced capacities. The months ahead will be pivotal for their survival. They need to know that they are permitted to operate outdoors for the next 2 years so that they can invest in purchasing fixtures such as tents and umbrellas necessary for outdoor dining.
As announced this week, eligibility for the COVID-19 vaccine has expanded and is now available to individuals 65 years of age or older and to those between the ages of 16 through 64 with medical conditions as defined by the CDC that increase the risk of severe illness from the virus. If you are eligible to receive the vaccine, we strongly urge you to get it. You can pre-register at covidvaccine.nj.gov to make an appointment at a site near you to get your first vaccine dose. This has been the Senate Democrats Week in Review. Thanks for watching.